a man, a woman, a robot.
So my name is Layla Hirsch, for those who don't know. I was adopted from Russia at 8 years old, and I have a twin sister. So we're very fortunate to be able to come here and kind of start a new life and get an opportunity to wrestle. So the dream of me wrestling came when I was 14 years old. I had a best friend who loved WWE. And one night, you know, we were just flipping through channels and he put on Friday Night SmackDown. So, you know, he looks at me and he was like, you know what this is? I was like, no. So as I'm watching it, he's explaining it to me. And it's R-Truth against Mike Knox. And just watching them two go at it, that was when I said, you know what? I could see myself doing that. I fell in love with it right there and then. And afterwards, I went downstairs and I went to my mom and I was like, hey mom, you know, do you know what WWE is and all that? She was like, yeah. And I'm like, what is it gonna take to make it, to be in WWE, to be that superstar? And she was like, honestly, start wrestling. So that night, that was my dream. That's what I wanted to do growing up. And a year afterwards, I started doing amateur wrestling, which I ended up falling in love with. So I started with amateur wrestling for a little bit. I did it for straight 5 years. And I ended up committing to it so much that I decided to do it in college. So I got offered a scholarship to Life University, which is in Georgia, to wrestle there, but I ended up giving it up. While wrestling in high school, an amateur, being on the guy's team, once in a while, we had a girl from PA come. And one day we were just talking about our goals and what we wanted. And I told her that my main dream is to be in WWE. And she was like, oh, well, I know a professional wrestler. And I was like, ah, okay. So she gave me the name, and a lot of you know this person. That guy is David Starr. She gave me his number, and I texted him right away. And within 2 minutes, he replied. It's crazy because I texted him, we went back and forth a little bit, and then he called me. We talked a little bit about then. And then he asked if I wanted to meet up with him. So I was like, okay. So the day I met up with him, it was a Saturday, and that day was a CZW show. Prior to this, I had no idea what indie wrestling was. All I knew was TNA and WWE. And I might've heard of Lucha Underground. Other than that, no knowledge of indie wrestling, no knowledge of CZW at all. So I met him at Dunkin' Donuts and we just talked about the business and everything, what it takes, you know, how you gotta go about things. And then afterwards, he brought me to the CZW show. I got there, I met DJ, who's the owner, and right away, I just began helping, setting up and all that. When it came time to the show, I was blown away with it. You know, I was just such a, I was going crazy for it. I was marking out, you know? And at the end of it, I was like, you know what? I gotta do this now. I gotta take the opportunity and just do it. Because after the show, I talked to DJ. He explained to me some of the stuff. And he was just like, why don't you come down and have a tryout? So that Monday I came, had the tryout, killed it, got in the ring. And right there and then, my dream was coming true. That was my dream. And just the fact that I got to step in that ring that day, it meant so much to me. So I decided to give up my scholarship, give up amateur wrestling, because I thought this could be a better opportunity. You know, I was young, still am, you know, but I was 19 at that time. And I thought, if I don't take this now, I don't know where I'm gonna be if I take it 4 years later or 5 years. So I decided to give it up, and it was tough because my parents weren't too happy about it. Definitely, it was a fight. Definitely had to fight for it, but the first time ever, like, I knew that's what I wanted to do. And nothing was gonna stop me from that, nothing. So it's been a crazy ride, but I have no regrets with anything. Yes. Yeah. Because I've lived there for 8 years, and at 8 years old, that's when I was officially adopted. But those 8 years, like, I lived in an orphanage, with, like, tons of kids, and it was like half and half. Like, half of it was great, half of it was like really bad, you know. But leaving the country, you know, I knew some of what was happening, but I knew I wasn't going to get to see the people that I was with. And time to time, you know, I think about Russia a lot, and I will one day revisit. I will one day go back and, you know, just revisit Russia, you know, and just get a better tour of it. But I do miss it a lot. So growing up, my favorite was Jeff Hardy. I absolutely loved him. All the craziness that he did, putting his body on a line every single night. It was crazy. And then, you know, like, I gotta say, like, John Cena, Randy Orton, Triple H, some of the girls, Beth Phoenix, Natalya, Michelle McCool, you know, Lita, Trish. And now, Mercedes Martinez. She is one of the top people I admire. When I, 2 years ago, I met her at the airport for the first time. I picked her up, and right away, I was like, wow, she's a badass. And then when I got to see her in the ring, I was like, she blew me away too. Like, I knew that that's the kind of wrestling I wanted to do, you know? But then people like Tessa Blanchard, she's pretty incredible too. Mia Yim, Nika Satomura. There's a whole list of them now that I just admire. And if I ever get a chance, would love to take them on. I think it's a lot better because for me, it's not all about the looks. I love the wrestling part of it. And I think when I saw NXT Sasha versus Bayley, to me, that's what women's wrestling is. It's not all about just the looks and looking sexy. It's about the competition too, you know? When I wrestle, I wanna be compared to guys. I wanna wrestle like guys. When I get in the ring, I wanna be treated equally. Not any less. So seeing them right now, even seeing like Ronda Rousey on the roster, I think we're heading in a good direction. And after seeing Women's Evolution live, it's even more inspiring. it's just more inspiring. I think a lot of it is you get to be who you are. You get to be yourself. And you also get to take whatever stress, life distractions you have, and just when you get in that mat, when you get in that ring, you get to take it out on your opponent. You just get to forget everything else, because when you get in that ring, that's all that matters. It's just you and your opponent. Everything else kind of just goes away. And again, every time I step in that ring, I'm saying to myself, I am living my dream. I was meant to be this. So, yeah. Oh man, super, super excited. First time I saw Cage of Death, I couldn't believe the kind of craziness that went on. And now being here for almost 3 years, I can't imagine what's gonna happen this year at Cage of Death, especially because it's at the 2300 Arena. It's a legendary building. And the fact that I will get to be in that building, performing, it's surreal, special moment. Like I said, she has become my dream match right now. She's my dream match. It's bittersweet, you know. Like I said, almost 2 years ago, I met her at the airport. I was picking her up at the airport and, you know, just saying to her how, wow, you know, one day I want to be able to face you. And now that it's happening, I got to own it and I got to take the opportunity and make it the best that I can. It's not just like, this is not just some match to me. This is very special. She's one of the best women's wrestlers I've ever seen. She's the best. And the fact that I'm going to have an opportunity and the pleasure to share the ring with her, very lucky, very lucky and fortunate to get that opportunity. So obviously, like, since I was 14, the main goal is WWE. But in 5 years, honestly, I know I'm gonna be able to travel. I wanna be able to travel the world. I wanna be able to inspire people. I wanna make myself known. I wanna be the name. And by then, I want to be known as one of the best female wrestlers. I have very high expectations for myself. And with CCW, I have a great team. I have a great support system. So in 5 years, I don't see why not. I can't do all that or accomplish any of that. I love movies. I love going to the movies. Anytime I get a chance, just go to the movies. Sports in general, like I just love going outside, you know, just whatever it is, basketball, soccer, lacrosse, anything. I love playing sports. The big thing is also hang with friends. Family time too. That's the most important thing. Spending time with family. Also have 2 dogs, which I love, you know. I love to eat also, like, love to eat. Food's so good. But honestly, like, I'm a chill person. I'm down to doing anything, you know. Yeah. That's hard. I mean, honestly, I love Russian food. So, I don't know, borscht, which is a soup, pierogies. Oh, pierogies are so good. I mean, American chicken franchise. I don't know if you guys know what that is, but I love anything. Bread. Bread is the biggest thing I love. Oh my God. That's the one thing I probably could not live without. I love bread. Just give me all that and I'll be good. I'll be satisfied. And cookies. Cookies too. Follow your dreams. I mean, you might have gotten that answer, or, you know, it might sound cliche, but honestly, follow your dreams. It's not easy. And for me, the hardest thing was going against my parents. But if you follow your dreams and you prove people wrong, that's the biggest thing for me, is proving people wrong. And when I prove my parents wrong and they see the success I'm having now, they're all in now. So sometimes you gotta go against what people think and say to you, and honestly say, fuck it, and just go after it. Go after it. And one day, it will pay off for you. It will. And with that also, surround yourself with good people, with positive people. They're gonna support that and gonna understand where you're coming from. You know, that's it's so big that you believe in yourself. It's one thing to have a dream, but it's another thing to make it reality and to go afterwards.